guys, welcome back to my channel. For today's video, I did a get ready with me because I really wanted to talk to you guys and update you in some things that are going on in my life. And because obviously I've been gone for the longest time already, so yeah, I had to talk to you guys. So I hope you guys like this video. It's not going to be a full-on tutorial. I'm going to have everything that I used on my face listed down below just in case anyone is curious. But it's not really going to be a tutorial because obviously the makeup is really, really easy, really simple, because that was the purpose. So hopefully you guys like this video and hopefully it's not way too long. But if it is, make sure you go grab a snack and yeah, keep on watching. So we do have a lot to talk about, you guys, a lot. Okay, so before we begin talking with the chisme, I'm just gonna go ahead and prime my eyelids. I know you guys are really, really mad at me, and I'm really mad at myself too because I've been gone for the longest time. I was gone for a month and then I started uploading again, and then I'm gone again for a week and a half or two. But I didn't upload this time this past week because I was sick. It was such a weird like sickness because I didn't feel sick. Like, my body felt great. I could do whatever. I didn't feel tired. I didn't feel anything. Like, I was energetic. Cool. But I had this cough that was really annoying. Like, I could literally feel something stuck here on my trachea and it was just annoying. And then when I would breathe out loud, like, you could hear something and it was annoying. Plus, that's not it. My voice was really, really nasty. Like, you could hear it, like, today is January the 1st, just in case anyone is wondering, and I'm gonna film today because I've been gone for the longest time, so on the first day of the year, I'm filming, so be proud of me. Okay, so I went to get some tape because I needed some tape in my life. I'm not a good multitasker. Like, I can't really concentrate on more than one thing. I don't know, I just love taking my sweet time. That comes with me being really slow, so I'm just a very slow person in general, and I take my time, you know, and I can't do more than one thing. So I'm not sure if I'm gonna be able to do this. Make sure you follow me on my vlog channel because I do have a vlog channel. I used to upload on it like when I had like 150 subscribers in this channel, but then I stopped. I only uploaded once. Like, I didn't upload that much, but I upload twice, and then I just have them on private so you guys can't really see them. So yeah, I haven't uploaded since then. But yeah, I want to start vlogging for you guys because I don't know, I just feel like it's so fun to vlog. So I do want to vlog. I also not only want to make it a vlog channel, but I also want to do challenges, pranks. I don't know, I just want to do fun things, you know? So if you guys are interested in something like that, make sure you go follow me on that channel because it's going to be more of those kind of things. I'm going to start uploading on that channel once I hit 1k. And if you guys are wondering, like, why am I gonna start uploading once I hit 1k, it's because your girl has to buy a vlogging camera, and it's kind of expensive, so it's kind of like my little procrastination thing. And also because, I mean, if I'm gonna invest, I want to make sure like enough viewers want to see that. So yeah, that's why I'm kind of waiting. So make sure you go follow me on that vlog channel if you want to see fun vlogs. Anything related to makeup, even if it's challenges, I'll do them here. But if it's different kind of challenges, then I'm gonna upload them over there. So make sure you go over there for all those things. I'll go ahead and leave it on the screen right here. And it's gonna be also down in the description box below. So you guys, I don't know if you guys can notice, but I actually cut my hair by myself and I dyed it a little bit. Let me stand up. Okay, so this is my hair length right now. It's like right below my boob, like right here, and my hip bones are actually over here. These are high-waisted, so my belly button is literally right here, so my hip bones are right here, and my hair is to be up to my hip bones, and I literally cut it by myself up to here. So I actually only meant to cut like 2 inches off, and I don't know how I ended up cutting like 4 or 5. And then I also dyed it. I actually dyed it before I cut it, so it was a lot more blondish from the bottom. This is my first time I ever dyed my hair. I used a little bit of bleach. I didn't really leave it for that long because I was afraid. It's my first time, so I was kind of afraid, you know? I didn't want to like F my hair up. But I do want to go a little bit lighter. I don't want to go completely blonde. I just want to do like that like brownish caramel color. So I did start off with very little hair because I wanted to try it out and I wanted to see if I could blend it because I don't want to end up with like a line. And I feel like my blending is okay, but I feel like I kind of need to stretch the little lines a little bit more. So I'm still gonna do another session. It's probably gonna be like in a week or two, and I'm gonna try to go a little bit higher. I do want to keep it going like that. I want to go very, very slow, just so I won't damage my hair a lot, because it's actually damaged. Like, I don't like it. I feel like I look better if I have my hair lighter. I don't know, it looks better on my complexion. So I'll see how it looks. I used to have it blonde. I'm not sure if you guys knew that, but I used to have it blonde. Obviously not real, it was dyed. And if you're wondering why the hell did I dye my hair, because it's actually kind of dangerous. It's not dangerous, but like you can mess up your hair. It's because when I was asking for the prices, it was super, super expensive. It was $300 for my hair, and I'm telling you, my hair was really long. So it was like, they would always tell me, oh, it's probably gonna be more than $275. I don't know what, it's gonna start there, depending on your hair, blah, blah, blah. And my hair, obviously it's really dark. So I was like, oh my God, like, I don't know if I could pay that much. Because once, when I used to have it, I think I used to have it a little bit shorter than this. That's when I dyed it blonde. I paid for the blonde. And they actually left it really, really ugly. Like, I cried. Like, literally, I cried, you guys. What makes me, like, mad is how the lady was like, it looks nice, when obviously it didn't look nice. You could literally see, like, a stripe right here, another stripe over here. Like, it was bad. It had, like, some spots of, like, platinum, and then some spots of blonde, and it was just, like, really ugly. I hated it, and I ended up wasting $200 and something for that. That's why I didn't want to pay $300, because what if I don't like it? I just feel like I kind of need to tone it a little bit more, because it's a little bit brassy. But I'm still gonna wait for the other session that I do, because I feel like toning it kind of damages your hair. So I'm just gonna wait a little bit more. By the way, I forgot to tell you guys, I got acrylics. I'm not sure if you guys can notice, but I did get acrylics. This is my second time I ever get acrylics. I don't know if I'm doing this correctly, because I feel like I'm dragging the color so high already that it's gonna look super weird once I take the tape off. So hopefully it doesn't look weird, because I'm like literally over here with the color. So I'm gonna go a little tiny bit darker. So pray for me. Does anyone have a YouTube channel? I'm curious to know, you guys. If you do, let me know down below, because I know it's kind of weird, but sometimes I love to watch like videos for my subscribers. I don't know, it's cute. Like, so yeah, definitely let me know down below so I could go watch you guys, and maybe I'll spam you. But even if it's not makeup related, I'm still down to watching, because it's interesting just knowing that you guys like see me. Like, I'm just interested in you guys's personality and you guys's like thoughts and stuff. I know it sounds kind of creepy, but I don't know, I find it interesting. It's like you're my friend and I'm just watching you, you know, like supporting you. That's what I'm trying to say. Like, it's just like you're my friend and I'm supporting you and I'm just interested. And yeah, so comment down below, you guys. Nice. So I did already wash my face again, because I'm gonna start doing my face makeup. I'll continue with the rest of my eyes later. Let's just go ahead and move on. I have this huge thing right here that I hate so much. Like, my skin was so good and I literally missed washing my face one whole day because I was so lazy. This actually even hurts. Like, I don't even know how my makeup is gonna look on top of that, because I just hope it looks good and I don't want it to look like bumpy or anything, because I don't like that. So I'm scared of it getting bigger because of the makeup. Okay, so I'm gonna use a dark concealer today. Wow, this is really dark. The reason why I'm gonna use kind of like a darker concealer, it's just like one shade darker, is because I'm gonna use a very light powder. Okay, my concealer just fell. Okay, so this is the light powder that I'm gonna use. Hopefully this works out. If not, I'm gonna be really, really sad. But this powder, I really love it. I used it in one of my videos like a long time ago, but it made my face look so white. The reason is because this is not a translucent powder. This is an actual colored powder. So I got a powder way too light for me and it made me look really, really white. So hopefully this method works better. If you guys want to get this powder, I really recommend it. Except you guys need to get your concealer shade. Make sure you get one way too light, because it's going to make you look really, really pale white. And it's gonna be hard to blend away because it is powder and it's just gonna stick to the concealer. Also, make sure you don't get one too dark because it's just gonna ruin your makeup and it's gonna be way too dark and you don't want that. Okay, so this powder made me look really, really matte. So I'm just gonna go ahead and spray something to my face really quick. I'm gonna spray some Fix Plus to my face. And you guys know that this is one of my favorite highlights. This is a sleek makeup highlighting palette. And this is in the color Solstice. And because it's a little too white, I always mix it because I don't like that pearly finish. I prefer more of a light champagne finish. So I decided to get the other color that they have, thinking it was gonna look really nice. And it's this one. It looks really pretty. It's a gold color. It's this one up here or this one. These two are creams. The problem is that it's way too dark for me, so it doesn't work. Like, I can't use it. So I didn't know this was supposed to be for like darker skin tones. I had no idea. So if you guys were planning on getting this and you are very fair, lighter than me or like kind of like me, I would say don't get it. Like, I wouldn't really recommend it because you might get that little stripe unless you don't mind mixing it with another highlighting palette. So that's what I'm gonna do today. Super random fact, but I feel like people for some reason think I'm really short. I don't know why I always seem to look short in my pictures and people think that I'm short, but I'm not that short. I mean, I'm not tall for sure, but I'm not short. I feel like I'm an average height, to be honest. Like, I don't think I would consider myself short at all, because if I say I'm short, you guys would think something else of me. You guys would think like a certain height and then you see me and I'm not that height. And if I say I'm tall, you guys would also think that I'm like a certain height and I'm not. I'm gonna be way too short for that. So I honestly feel like I am just average. If you guys are wondering my height, I am 5'3". I kind of feel like I'm already 4". Like, I don't know. I feel like I'm 5'3½ because when my friends tell me that they're 5'2", I'm like way taller than them. And it's just like, are you sure you're 5'2"? Because you're like really, you're supposed to be really close to me and you're way too short. But according to them, they are 5'2". So I'm just like, okay, maybe I'm wrong. I don't know. The other time I was talking with one of my friends, how like, it's so weird that I do makeup tutorials and I do these, you know, tutorials, and I don't wear like the makeup that I do. It's like, you would expect me to wear this, but I never wear this. I would never ever in my life do a smoky eye. Even if it's like this, a light brown, I wouldn't do a smoky eye. I do the whole full face, and I do the brows, except I only apply lashes. I never do eyeshadow, and then the lips are natural. And that's only when I'm getting ready. And if I'm not getting ready and it's just something a lot more natural, you know, like I still want to do my makeup, but it's more natural, I just do the full face and I only apply mascara and that's it. And then the last one that I do most of the time is literally just apply concealer. And sometimes I apply mascara, sometimes I don't. So I just apply concealer and I put my glasses on and that is it. That is how I go out. So I feel like I look so different from like what you would expect me to look like. You guys, this is literally my favorite combo ever. This is the NYX Soft Matte Lip Cream in London. I've been using it for the longest time already and I love it. Like, I already repurchased this so many times and I love it. I feel like it's the perfect nude where it looks like I'm not really wearing a lipstick, but I am. But I'm not, but I am. I think if you have a deeper complexion, it might not look so good. I'm not sure. But these two together look so, so good, you guys. This is the Dose of Colors lip gloss and over the top. And you guys, this is my favorite lip gloss in the whole wide world. This is so good, you guys. It looks so pretty in the sun and it looks so pretty not in the sun. I have never in my life gotten compliments over a gloss. But with this one, I don't know what's going on that I get compliments. So this is the way this one looks by itself. It looks very natural. And then I'm gonna apply the lip gloss. Okay, so this is the way that the liquid lip looks with the lip gloss. I think it looks really, really good. It's actually really, really wearable. Like, I literally wear it with anything and I love it. So pretty much, you guys, this is the end of this video. Thank you so much for watching. and for staying in all the way to the end. Make sure you put a super random emoji just so I could see that you guys stayed all the way to the end. I want to see who stayed. Put a plant emoji if you guys stayed all the way to the end, just so I could see which ones of you guys stayed to the end. Or even if you skimmed through the video, it's fine. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. And I'll see you in my next video, which will be very soon, I promise. Bye.